I would say 6-7.
And how do you feel about that?
I know that we need to prioritise increasing core benefits. People simply don't have enough to live their lives with dignity, and that's something we need to act urgently on.
So when you say urgently, by when?
The incomes have been kept inadequate for decades and through successive governments, in fact, Lisa, so this is ASAP. What that means is we need to put the legislation in place to raise those incomes.
Because speaking to the Minister on this program, she will give no commitment to raising benefits. Are you at loggerheads over this?
Oh, we're very clear that lifting core benefits, making sure people have enough to make ends meet, is something that needs to happen ASAP. It hasn't happened yet, and so that's definitely a question for the other parties. We're very clear, Greens are very clear on what we need to do.
So what has the Minister told you about this? Is she keen to do it this term or not?
Look, I want to say that Minister Carmel Sepuloni gets it. That I'm very clear of. She understands her background, her community work, her constituency. She gets that we need to see benefits and core benefit levels increased.
So who is the handbrake here then?
Again, we're working closely with the Minister to see how we can get this done. And, you know, it hasn't happened yet. That's a bigger question for all three political parties in government.
So why? Why hasn't it happened yet? If you're so determined about it and you say that the Minister gets it, why hasn't it happened yet? And why is there no commitment to make it happen this term?
I simply say to people, if we want to see it happen for sure and ASAP, we're going to need to see more Green MPs, because this is a very clear position for us. I can talk about what we want, what we know people need us
to increase incomes. And I'm really sorry to interrupt you, but that's an important point you make there. Have you resigned yourself to the fact that you're not going to get this in this term? You're talking about more Green MPs. That means another election. That means another term. That sounds like resignation.
No, we haven't given up. No, we haven't and will not give up. So we continue to work across ministers and with Minister Sepuloni to see this happen. We want to see something definitely this term. Absolutely, Lisa.
Is New Zealand First the fly in the ointment on this issue?
I will be really clear. That is a question for them. I am simply telling people we know what needs to be done. We want to ensure everyone has enough.
Why won't it happen?
Mm. And so that's for the other parties to talk to.
Why won't you be upfront with voters about what's going on here and what the barrier is to making this happen?
I think that's a fair question. And I think we're being very clear on what the Greens want. It hasn't happened. I think the people can work out, who it is that really wants to push this through. And so I am being quite upfront about it.
I can't work it out. So could you tell me, what is the barrier?
The Green Party are clear. This needs to happen ASAP. People need this to happen. It hasn't happened yet. We are three political parties. We haven't yet had that consensus, Lisa. Yes, that's very clear.
So is Labor in agreement with you on this particular issue or not? Yes or no?
This is a confidence and supply agreement, and we haven't yet been able to see incomes lifted, but we are continuing to work on it, Lisa.
Why don't you just say that New Zealand First is the one that doesn't want it, if that's true?
I'm here to talk about what the Greens stand for. I agree that people have a right to understand where political parties are at. I do think that's a question for them.
You're here as a government partner. So let me put it another way then. Can you define overhaul for me? What's your idea of an overhaul?
That people can live with dignity, and the incredible Welfare Expert Advisory Group termed an overhaul meaning as much, meaning that it is whakamana tangata, it is people living with dignity. At the moment, incomes are not enough for people to live with dignity, and they were clear that we need to prioritise raising incomes.
Okay, so that is the commitment you have in your agreement, your confidence and supply agreement, that the welfare system will be overhauled. You don't have that yet, and that is
not
a commitment for this term.
Yes.
So my question is, to achieve the goal of an overhaul, would you need to see baseline benefits go up this term?
Yes, we are clear.
So if you don't get that, you have failed and you haven't got your share of the government deal.
We're working on that. We do need to see something this term, Lisa, and that's what we're working on right now.
Carmel Cepeloni, when she came on Checkpoint, seemed to be suggesting that there is work going on behind the scenes and conversations are being had. What are those conversations? You must be party to them.
There is always work going on behind the scenes. Of course,
but specifically,
Lisa,
specifically.
I think people will understand that we can't share all the details of those conversations, that I don't want to compromise the work that we do in a stage that is too early. But I do need to let people know we are fighting hard to see a welfare system that treats people with dignity, including lifting core benefits.
How can you expect people to support you when you will not be clear about what they can expect, what's coming?
I understand the need out there, and we've been very clear that we understand, the Greens understand the need out there, and I will be clear with people. We want to see incomes lifted. The welfare advised between 12% to 47% increase, and I can be very clear with people that that's what we want to see. We want to see that recommendation put in place. I can be clear that we are working solidly on putting that through right now.
So hang on, if you don't get this though before the end of this term, then do you personally think you will have failed in the field of welfare?
Personally, I feel like we are failing right now to ensure that people can live with dignity. So yes, I'm really concerned about this, Lisa. If we don't do this, then people won't have faith and hope that we want to see a fair New Zealand where people can make ends meet. So yes, I am absolutely wearing that on my shoulders and on our shoulders as the Green Party.
So you would consider that a failure if you do not get this in this term?
Lisa, I'm focused on doing the work rather than looking at what will be a failure. I'm focused on doing the work to get through an overhaul to lift incomes, and that is what I'm thinking about every single day.
I understand that, and the thing is, people have voted for you on this basis, and obviously you've got an agreement with this government. So I'm going to ask you one more time. If you don't get this, given it is your core focus, will you have failed to achieve the welfare reform that you want?
Yes, if we don't get this, we will have failed to assist people to live with dignity. I can be really upfront about that.
I just want to ask you this one more time. I'm sorry, before we go. You want this. You say you will have failed if you don't get it. You're telling me that the minister is sympathetic to what you want. Who or what is stopping you getting it?
Well, clearly, this is something that the Greens would have put in place already. And so it's a question for the other political parties. And that's one that I agree that they should be questioned on.
Well, what are they saying to you? Why won't you name what's stopping you? Because you clearly in your head know what you think the answer is. Why won't you articulate it? What are you afraid of?
I can talk about where I'm coming from. I really don't think it's for me to talk about where other political parties are coming from. I simply know we haven't yet made the changes that need to be made.
Let me put it another way. Have you talked New Zealand First around to your position? Do they agree with this raising of benefits this term?
I do not know what their thoughts are. This is a confidence and supply agreement with Labour, and with the Minister is who we're working with. I cannot stand here and talk about what New Zealand First believes in.
Has the Minister given you a reason for why she hasn't set a date for a commitment to raising benefits, baseline benefits?
We do have those discussions and are working very closely. And again, I can tell people that we're working really hard to put this in place, that the minister gets it, and we're just trying to do that work. And I know what you're trying to say, that people need to see this done, and I agree with that. And I simply am saying we're trying to work through that. Some of the stuff I won't be able to share yet. Not quite yet, but I'm really working and prioritising lifting incomes and having those conversations.